Venetian is a picturesque village in the Devonshire countryside and home to the majestic country house, Venetian Court. The estate has a long agricultural history and is now a cattle farm owned and run by Jonathan Cumming, whose livestock includes Tom the Turkey.
Come on in, this is the library.
What a house. It couldn't be more British if it tried. It's really genuinely beautiful. So you bought the house empty?
Yes.
It takes an lot to find all this stuff to fill a house of this size. Ah, right. So what's in here that's potentially to go then?
There's a little side table there.
Yeah. This has seen better days, hasn't it?
It's a little bit of TLC. Yeah.
I can get that done. It's just a bit of a pain to do. I don't know. What do you want for it?
A couple hundred.
Yeah, OK. Yeah, let's have it. That's fine. I'll take it on. My restorer is not going to be very happy.
This 19th century side table is made from ebonized wood, which is a process where inexpensive timbers were stained and waxed to look like ebony, a darker, more exotic and expensive wood. The decorative gold details are pieces of ormolu, which are bronze sections gilded with gold. To achieve this effect, a mixture of mercury and gold powder were applied to the bronze and heated. The mercury would burn off first, leaving an opulent gold coating. It's a gilding technique that originated in 17th century France, but is no longer used due to the poisonous mercury fumes it produces. Once restored back to its former glory, this ornate little table could be worth around £800.
What a place. Like a sort of little slice of heaven living there, isn't it? He's created his own little world, and I want Jonathan to adopt me. I've adopted a 51-year-old Welshman.
Yeah, we're hoping he grows up soon.
Before they head off to buy yet more stock, Drew and T have made a pit stop to drop off the ebonized side table to antiques dealer and expert furniture restorer, Richard Rush. The table came with a kit of spare parts, so before he starts, Richard wants to know exactly what he has to work with.
Well, that looks like...
Like a jigsaw puzzle, the pieces fit in perfectly.
I've stuck on all the pieces that I found, but I'm left with a situation where two pieces are missing. So we're going to start by pushing this piece into the clay. That should give me what I need to make a mold.
Traditionally, they would have been cast in bronze, but using plaster is a simpler and cheaper method that gives very similar results. Once set, the new sections need to be trimmed, then transformed from white to gold using metal leaf. But the shiny new pieces need dulling down.
And we can see it's starting to blend in.
Once the new ormolu pieces that Richard has made are stuck on, the table is complete.
It's looking really classy. Bit by bit, we've put it back together. I think it really shines.